hear my testimony of God's long suffering love to save a sinner like me. I was baptized a Catholic when I was a baby. I was about 3 months old when I was baptized into the Catholic Church. I served as an altar server for many years. I tried to attend the Mass once a week at least. However, deep in my heart, I know that something is still not right. And then, to be exact, on the 9th of October, 1998, I experienced the most amazing experience in my life. It was the day when I was baptized by God the Holy Spirit. I am born again. You notice that I am not using past tenses to describe my born again experience. To me, once I become born again, I am always a born again. To me, there is no such thing like I was a born again. Ever since that day, my life will never be the same. I was making a sharp U-turn towards the loving arm of God. All of a sudden, I know God loves me so much that He gave His only Son to save me from the death of sins. All of a sudden, the Bible is so alive, as if you were given a key to an enormous room with a huge library of God's instruction, which I can understand in my own term. A lot of God's words, which I struggled to understand in the past, all of a sudden were explained to me in clear text. All of a sudden too, I have a lot of respect to the Holy Mass. When I go to Mass, I no longer attend Mass. Instead, I celebrate Mass. Believe me, that after attending Mass since I was little, I know all of the prayers by heart. I know exactly when to sit, to kneel, or stand, or what the priest is going to say at minutes 22 and 41 seconds, for instance. All by heart. To me, the Mass was only a ritual. I had no understanding of the sacredness of the Holy Mass. God is so graceful. He opens the eyes of my heart as we just sing. All of a sudden, I can see the holiness of the Holy Mass. I now understand that the Mass is a gift for me, a gift of God's love. God is telling me that He wanted to be in communion with me. For the body of our Lord Jesus become one with my body, and His blood to become one with my blood running through my brain. The Holy Mass is to prepare us towards this union. Jesus' body and blood are so pure and sacred that we have to prepare our sinful body, our heart, our mind, and our soul to be in communion with God. I now understand how the Holy Mass prepare us through the process. First, we confess our sins and ask for God's forgiveness. Through the prayer, I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned. Then, we feast on the words of God through the reading of the books of the Bible. But currently, we keep on praising God through reading of the Psalm. Then, we are reminded of the love of God when we walk the earth in human form through the reading of the Gospel of our Lord Jesus. Through the homily, the priest, under the guidance of God the Holy Spirit, will remind us of God's teaching, His love, and His promises to us. The priest will then lead us to reconfirm our commitment of faith through the creed. I believe in one God, the Creator of heaven and earth. Then we move towards the most sacred moment, to the Holy Eucharist, when the bread and wine become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus, which were sacrificed to save us from our sinful death. I now know that we are taking all the steps before we are worthy to be in communion with God. The Mass to me is now a truly holy and sacred event, which I look forward to, instead of just an hour of ritualistic event. The Mass is not some event that we can take lightly. The Mass is sacred. Ever since I was born again, I also have a lot of questions. Some are very intense, and some questions were answered by God right away. I have a very fundamental question to God. What is the meaning of the cross? It was during Lent season when I had this conversation with God. I said, God, what is the meaning of Good Friday and Easter Sunday? During Good Friday, I read about the Passion of Christ. I read through the Bible. I watched a few movies, including The King of Kings and a few others. This is before the Passion of Christ movies. They don't make sense to me. The whole things are just like a story in a movie. Jesus is the lead actor, and the Bible is just like a script. It was intended for the beginning that Jesus had to die on the cross. He would be punished by the Roman soldiers. He would suffer. He would be hung on the cross. Also, we celebrate his death and resurrection in every Mass that I attended. He has died. He is risen. He will come again. It was not making sense. Why did Jesus die for me? Why did he have to die on the cross? That was my fundamental question. Still, I don't understand. I said to God, it doesn't make any sense to me. Then, one day, I remember that morning, I was driving to work. God gave me the answer to my question. It was not through an audible voice of God talking to me. Neither were they through what I see or what I hear. God's answer was given directly in my heart. It was like an intense and real experience. Imagine that I was in an operating room. The surgeon told me that I have a fatal failure of my heart. I was dying and will die very, very soon if I don't get a new heart. And then, all of a sudden, a very healthy person walked in. His name is Jesus. He insisted that the surgeon took his heart to give to him. The surgeon did as he was taught to do. Jesus then gave his heart to me, so that he then died, and then I may live. I was so grateful and emotional at the same time that I cried profusely that day. I had to stop the car, because I cannot stop crying. I kept on thanking God for his love, but at the same time, I kept on asking him, why does he love me so much? Today, I will never stop thanking him for his love and promise him the best that I know how to serve him with all my life.